In this video, we'll go over how to graph a line if you know a point on the line and its slope. For example, graph the line that passes through the point -3, -4 and has slope of 3/2. Well, we know one point on the line, -3, -4, so we could start with that. So we could add a piece of graph paper, and we're going to plot the point -3, -4. So here's the center at the origin. You go -3, -4, and we have one point on the line. Now, we're going to use the idea of slope and rise over run to find another point. So we know that the slope is rise over run. So the trick is to write the slope as a fraction, which actually it is written. It's 3/2, right? So we've written it as a fraction. And then we want to put signs in for the numerator and denominator so that it stays positive 3/2. So we could think of that as +3/+2. Therefore, figuring out if we do a run of +2 and a rise of +3, we should find another point on the line. All right, so we have to start from our starting point, which is -3, -4, and we need to go a run of what's in the denominator, +2, 2 to the right, and then a rise of +3, which is up 3. And there's another point on the line. Now, you could just do this again from this new point. You do a run of +2, and you go up 3, and I have another point on the line. And this is a nice thing to do. This is what's cool about slope. If you don't have a straight edge with you, it's easier to connect the dots when they're close together. And so I could keep going until I run out of space. Now the question is, how can I get a point to the left? Keep in mind that you can also write the slope, as long as it reduces to 3/2, we're okay. So we could multiply the top and bottom by -1, and then that would be -3/-2. If you want to think about it that way, watch what happens from my starting point, -3, -4. I could do a run of -2, which means 2 to the left, and then go down 3, because the rise is -3, which means it goes down, and there we have it. So there's always going to be at least two ways you can write the slope. If you have a minus in front of the fraction part, that's not as helpful. You want to put it either in the numerator or the denominator. So now I could graph my line by connecting the dots. So I've drawn the line, and then the question is, does that pass through the point -3, -4? And does it look to you like it has a slope of +3/2? Yes. Let's do another one. One more quick note about this. You could have written this as 6/4. You could write any fraction that reduces to 3/2. And if you start from this first point, -3, -4, and do the rise over run of any fraction, you will still end up with a point on the line. So for instance, another way to write 3/2, multiplying the top and bottom by 3, for instance, would be 9/6. And if I started here at the bottom, if I went over 6 and up 9, I do get this point on the graph as well. You could also go over 2 inches and 3 inches. You just have to go over whatever unit you want. It's easier if you use graph paper, use the units on the graph. But you could go over 2 feet and up 3 feet, and you would also get a point on that line. So here's another one. Graph the line that passes through 2, -4 and has slope of -3/5. Okay, so always the first thing we're going to do is plot the point we know that's on the line. So we're going to plot 2, -4. So here's x, here's y, and starting from the origin, we're going to go over 2, -4. Next, we want to write the slope as a fraction. Now, it's written as -3/5. What I mean is to write it as a fraction without the minus sign out in front like that. So notice it's negative, so that means Either the numerator or the denominator needs to be a negative number, and the other needs to be a positive. So I could write this as negative 3 over positive 5. So remember, we've got the rise over the run. All right, so let's say we use that. So from my point, t negative 4, I'm going to run 5, positive 5. So I'm going to go to the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then I'm going to go down 3. Now, if I do it again, I'm going to be, way off my graph paper that I've drawn here. So that's why it's nice to know. And by the way, right here, you can go ahead and draw the line. But let's say I wanted to get a few more points, or at least one more point. I could have written it as positive 3 over negative 5. That will also work, because that also reduces to negative 3/5. And if I use this instead, I'll get some points to the left of my ordered pair. And in fact, any time the denominator is negative, you'll get ordered pairs to the left. And when the denominator is positive, obviously you're going to find some points to the right. So starting from my point 2, negative 4, if I had written it as positive 3 over negative 5, I would go to the left 5 spaces, and then I would go up 3, and that would be right here, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up 3. And I could do that again. From this point, I can go to the left 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up 3. And now I have a lot of points, a little bit easier to go ahead and draw the line through those points. Now, does that look like if I drew a line that I've got a slope of negative 3/5? It is slanting in the direction that it has a negative slope, and it is going through the point 2, negative 4. So the last thing is to simply get out something straight, be careful, and draw a straight line as best you can. And so there's the line. All right, here's one more. Graph the line that passes through 2, negative 1 and has slope of negative 3. So we're first going to plot 2, negative 1. Always take one point, the point you know it goes through, and at least get that on your graph. So I've got 2, negative 1. And then starting from that point, we want to find another point by using the slope. So we need to write the slope as a fraction. All right, so how are we going to write negative 3 as a fraction? Well, we could write negative 3 over positive 1. Or we can write positive 3 over negative 1. Or we could write it a whole bunch of other ways. For instance, negative 6 over positive 2 or something like that. So we have to choose one of these to find some more points. So we're going to start at the point, and let's use this first slope, negative 3 over positive 1. So I'm going to go and run positive 1, 1 to the right, and down 3, and I've got another point. And do it again, over 1 to the right, and down 3. And of course, that's all I can get. I'm going to get off my graph, right? So how about instead we use the positive 3 over negative 1 from my starting point of 2, negative 1? That would mean my run is negative 1. That means go to the left 1 and up 3. And to the left 1 and up 3, and you can see I can get a lot more points by using that slope. Now, a common mistake is to use the slope starting from the origin, and make sure you don't do that. You've got to start from the point that's on the line for sure, which in this case was 2, negative 1. So my last step here would be to connect the dots. So there's the line. All right, so reviewing, the steps are to plot the point, write the slope as a fraction, and use the idea of rise over run to find more points on the line.